This animation details a one-dimensional example of frequency encoding. The top horizontal array of red arrows show the transverse magnetization vector of 6 voxels, labeled 1 through 6. The thickness of the arrows represents their strength. Here, voxel 3 is the strongest. Below them are two sets of timelines. The right side incorporates frequency encoding, while the left side does not. For both sides, the top timeline shows the RF power causing the initial 90-degree spin flip, followed by the 180-degree spin flip required for the spin echo. The second timeline shows application of the Z gradient required for slice. The third timeline shows the application of the frequency encoding magnetic gradient along the X or horizontal direction. The fourth line shows the time window when signal is required for image formation, and the bottom line shows the entire signal. For this animation, only inhomogeneity phasing is used, for which the 180-degree pulse produces an echo. Initially, all spins flip and precess in unison until application of the frequency encoding gradient in the X or horizontal direction. Application of the gradient causes a slightly larger Z magnetic field towards the right-hand side and a slightly smaller Z magnetic field towards the left-hand side. This causes a known adjusted frequency change, such that spins precess with a higher frequency to the right and a lower frequency to the left. In effect, the x-axis location of each spin becomes encoded by its corresponding frequency. Notice that the frequency encoding gradient is applied during formation of the echo and coincides with acquisition of the signal. Since the acquired signal is a summation of signals at different frequencies, a Fourier transform is used to extract the magnitude of each frequency component. Since each frequency corresponds to a unique position along the x-axis, the Fourier transform, in effect, separates and identifies the signal from each voxel along the x-axis. This is shown at the end of this sequence as a spectrum at the bottom. Notice the right-hand spectrum shows 6 different peaks, each representing the magnitude of the corresponding magnetic moment 1 through 6. Observe that the highest peak at position 3 corresponds to the thickest arrow. The left-hand spectrum only shows one peak, since a frequency gradient was not applied, and therefore a Fourier transform will not separate the 6 components.